Krakatoa. Now, what is this Anak Krakatoa is an island. While making the Anak Krakatoa, behind that is a long story that we will see today in detail. Now, Anak Krakatoa. First, that is, we learn just a Krakatoa. Anak Krakatoa, this name, it's gave to that island afterwards. Before of this island's name is Krakatoa, just a Krakatoa. And this is an island in the Sunda Strait between Java and Sumatra. Okay, there is a place, Java and Sumatra. And Krakatoa Island is situated between Java and Sumatra, which is situated in Indonesia. And it is famous for its volcano, which erupts regularly. Okay, Anak Krakatoa, this name is given to them island afterwards. But before, the name of that island is Krakatoa. So that's the reason it's mentioned over here now, Krakatoa, because at present the name of that island is Krakatoa. And it is very much famous just for its volcano eruption. Now, it has happened regularly, volcano eruption, but this a volcano. You must be learn about the volcano eruption in your science chapter. Okay. A volcano is a crack or opening in the earth crust. If you saw a earth surface, if it is crust, crack, or opening the mouth of the earth, at that time, there is a hot molten rock. It's move out. Lava, it's come out. Okay. Earth centers. Sometime it rises to the surface of the earth through such a cracks or opening and flow out all the things like a rocks, mud, lava. It's moved out. It's flow out. When this happens, we say that the volcano has erupted. Okay. Now, erupts means what? Erupted means what? And eruption means what? That is burst out suddenly or explode or burst out. Okay. And then after volcano eruptions happens, it's happened tremendously. That means it's happened regularly. And when it's happened, you can see that clouds. See, a dark clouds, you can say a smoke, it's come out from that eruptions. When the opening the mouth of the earth surface or that the mountain, so the clouds has come out and it's boom. Okay, and it's spread in the sky. A big glowing burning chunks of rock and red hot lava are thrown out of the crack in the earth. Lava, as I told you, when the earth surface, it's crack, it's opening, at that time from inside, the hot molten rock, the hot rocks, the lava, the mud, ashes, all the things are comes out, okay? All the things are comes out. Chunks, you can say a lump, a roughly cut lump. Have you seen the jaggery lump? Okay, in this way only, that is a one lump, but that is very rough and fire lump, you can say. So that lump is come out from that place. Okay, and when the situation is take place, that we called a volcanic eruption. Okay, a volcanic eruption. Understand? So a very hot mud and ashes are also thrown out. A great volcanic eruption can change the landform in an area. Landform, there are, because when it's happened, you can see the area, the situation is totally changed. So that's the reason is saying here, when the volcanic eruption take place, the landform can change in that particular area. Okay, so now here, see, this is a picture of the volcanic eruption. When it take place, once again, when it take place, you can see this is a mob, or you can say ashes. Okay, burning chunks of rock. As I told you, just like a lump, it's come out, roughly lump, but it is a burning or fire lump. You can see this is the red hot lava. This is the lava, a fire lava. If you touch, no, so person will die. It's not possible to stay there. This is a crack in the earth crust. When the earth is crust, crack, so that means the earth mouth is opening, cracks are there. So from because of this crack, the lava and the hot burns, the smokes can move out. The hot molten rock, the hot, say a melted rock. Why? When the melted, because the fire of that rock is melted. And this is the earth crust. Again, the earth crust. Everyone's know crust, that means the harder outer covering of something. Harder outer covering, that means the outer layer part, hot outer layer part of the earth surface. When it crust, when it's open, at that time the hot lava, the smoke, the lashes, the chunks of rocks, the burning rocks are come out from that particular place. Okay, so this volcanic eruptions, it took place regularly in Krakatoa, not an Krakatoa, only just in a Krakatoa. Okay, now come to the next. Now there are the popularly classified into three categories. Which things? Volcanic. Volcano is classified into three categories. The first is active volcano, second is dormant volcano, and third is extinct volcano. Okay, these are the three categories of volcano. This is the active volcano. Active volcano means what? Active volcano, that means erupts regularly, where the burst out suddenly, regularly. That is the active volcano. The volcano, it take place regularly. As you can see, the active means what? Where you are regularly do your work. So here the volcano, which is active. Dormant volcano. Dormant volcano means what? Means temporarily inactive. You can say the opposite of active. Dormant, that means temporarily inactive, in a deep sleep. And we find information about the eruption of this volcano in a history. In a history, it happens, but now they are quiet. Okay. Because when the geographical search, they learn, they study about the landform. So that time they come to know, because in the history, this island is burst, a volcanic eruption take place temporarily, but now they are quiet. And it take place in a history time, that means in a past. But at present, it is a quiet. No volcanic eruption take place over there. That particular land, you can say a dormant volcano. Now the third is an extinct volcano. Extinct volcano means what? Means a geographers, that I told you, geographers, that person who collect the information and study about the different landforms, that you called a geographers. A geographers can guess by looking at the rock formation, and they used to erupt long ago, but there is a no record of it in history. There is a no record in history. That means geographers see the landform, they study about it, and it's erupt, but long ago, and there is a no record in a history. But they come to know that in this place, volcanic eruption is take place. How? When they took the landform pieces and they search in the search center and they study about it, at that time they understood in this land, the volcanic eruption took place. But there is a no history, but there is a no record in the history. Okay, so this you can say extinct volcano. An extinct volcano is unlikely to erupt again. Unlikely erupt again. That means not possible to erupt, burst out again. Okay, not possible. Not possible to take a eruptions again. Okay, so there we'll see a three types of volcano. Active volcano, where the volcano take active again and again regularly. Okay, we see a dormant volcano. We see a dormant volcano where the volcano, it take place in a history time. Okay, but now they are quiet. It is a temporary or inactive. Now, and third we are see extinct volcano. Extinct volcano, that means long, long ago it's happened. But there is a no record in history. There is a no record in history, but geographers are study about, and then after they come to the conclusion that volcano eruption took place, but there is a no record in history. And now it is unlikely to erupt again. That means not possible to erupt again. So here our three types is over. Now come to the next. Next is about our Krakatoa. Now, Krakatoa is an active volcano. Okay, means Krakatoa Island. There it's happened regularly volcano eruption. It has erupted many times, causing disaster. Okay, and the most dangerous disaster, a worst eruption, took place in August 1883. Which year? 1883 it took place. The volcano erupted with such a loud, very huge loud voice, boom. Okay, like as you can see in a film, students, that when you throw the bomb or something else, okay, so just like a in a your Diwali when you throw the firecrackers, how loudly the boom sound is come out. It take 100 times long that boom sound has come out. Okay, so that was heard more than 35,000 kilometer away in Australia. Just you can imagine 35,000. It's a 35,000. Okay, here will come 35,000. Kilometer long they heard in Australia. It is believed to be the loudest sound that man had ever heard. Okay, it is a very loudest sound. The island which was volcanic eruption, okay, the mountain is totally collapsed. Now, collapse means what? To fall down suddenly because of the huge pressure, a lack of strength. So, it's collapsed. The whole big mountain is collapsed. The dust that was thrown up in the eruption to about 80 kilometers in the sky. It spread all over the sky, almost 80 kilometers in the sky. Okay, and the sound and the boom sound is spread almost 35,000 kilometer long in Australia, and the clouds dust all is spread 80 kilometer in the sky, and it spread in the sky around the world and let us settle in the different parts of the world thousands of kilometer away. Because it spreads all over, so their dust, it spread and later it settled in the thousand of kilometer away in a different world. Okay, so you can imagine in 1883, Krakatoa, okay, 1883 in Krakatoa, that is was a huge and worst volcanic eruption took place. Okay, and whole the island was collapsed, totally collapsed, or you can say destroyed. Come to the next. Now, eruption caused giant waves. Now, because of this volcanic eruption, a giant waves, or you can say a tsunami, is also come over there. Now, giant means what? Giant means a huge amount of waves, a very large. So you can say a tsunami is there because of this eruption. And about, because of this eruption, about 165 villages and towns were destroyed. 165 villages are destroyed. Why it's happened? Because of volcanic eruption. And through the volcanic eruption, the tsunamis also take place there. So because of this two disaster, 165 villages, towns were destroyed. Okay, the eruption destroyed 2/3 of the island of Krakatoa. 2/3 part of Krakatoa island. Now 2/3 part means what? Now suppose this is the island, full island area. Okay, you can say this is the 2/3 part is destroyed. Completely destroy. Only this much part is remaining. Okay. So you can say a very much part it's destroyed about the Krakatoa Island, or only few parts is remaining, which is stay properly. Okay. So due to eruption and the tsunami, lots of destroyed thing and lots of problematic things is arises during of eruption. Okay, so it collapsed, island is collapsed, and beneath the surface of the sea. Beneath means what? That means under, or you can say a down. Beneath you can say a down, a below. Because see, it's the earth surface, okay, and all the island is collapsed. So it will take the earth surface down, a huge underwater volcanic crater. It's make a volcanic crater. Now, what is this volcanic crater? As you can see, student, suppose if the volcanic eruption took place, you can see the hole there, a large hole in the ground, that only you can say a volcanic crater. And this hole is beneath, that means the underground. It's too much deep hole. Okay, it's too much deep hole. It is inside in the sea water also. Below, very deep hole it is. And how much it is? It is almost 6 kilometer wide. 6 kilometer, that means suppose this is the area of your sea. Okay, this is the radius 3 kilometer. This is the diameter. So 6 kilometer, this area, that much there is the hole in between of the sea, or you can say in between of that mountain, because it is start from the mountain and it goes touch to the sea water under beneath. Understood? So that much the hole is occur at center in the sea. Okay, so then after what happened? So in 1883, this volcanic eruption take place, and you can see lots of changes is also occurs. 165 villages are destroyed. Tsunamis also take place. And there is a hole. Crater is also make just because of the volcanic eruption. Then after, again, something is happened in 1927 again. First eruption took place in 1883. Now second is also happened in 1927. Then in 1927, a plump of smoke. Now what is this plump? Plump, that you can say a smoke rises in the air. problem, you can say, a smoke arises in the air. As you can see in your picture, there is a smoke. You can say a plume of smoke. It's rise out of the water on the crater. As I told you, student, a large hole, a deep large hole is occurs under the water. So from there, a plume of smoke is rise out. Okay. And that smoke is too much smoke, as you can see in this picture, is rises out. Okay, so it was followed by another eruption. That means again the second eruption took place. A few days later, a new island volcano broke water. Now, just because of this another volcanic eruption, a new island occurred there. But how did it happen and how it take place? Let me see this. How the new island it's arise there. Okay. When the underwater volcano threw up ash and rocks. As before, only I'll explain you, student, how the volcano it's take place. When the volcano it's happen, at that time what happened? All the ashes, rocks, lava, melt rock, burning rock is throw out. Right, the earth crust is open the mouth and all this fire crackers is come out. When all the ashes and rocks is come out, it was quickly taken away by the sea water. Because it happened in between of the sea, na, so it's taken away the sea water. But when the lava started flowing out from that large hole, very fast has come out. At that time, what happened? Volcanic material was not taken away from the sea, from the waves. Because the lava is come out too much and very forcefully. So the sea cannot take them away and is stuck over there only. And with the help of this, a new mountain began to grow. Because all the ashes and rocks, they are flew out. But the lava, the hot lava which has come out, they cannot be flew out. And because of this, a new mountain began to grow over there. And kept growing, was soon seen above the water. It's little bit slowly that new island, or you can say a new mountain, it start to grow up. Thus a new island grew from the old island of Krakatoa. As you can see, this one is the old island Krakatoa, and from the old island a new island is grow. A new island is grow over there just because of this old island. Okay, and what is the name of this new island? Its name was Anak Krakatoa. Anak Krakatoa, or you can say child of Krakatoa. Anak Krakatoa, or you can say a child of Krakatoa. Child of Krakatoa. Because this is an old mountain, and with the help of this old mountain only, the new mountain it's grew up. So that's the reason this new mountain name is So this new mountain name is Anna Krakatoa, or you can say child of Krakatoa. Okay, why? Because it grew up old Krakatoa, that means the old mountain. Okay, now the Anna Krakatoa is still active. Anna Krakatoa is still active, an active volcano eruption has begun again since 1994. See student, the first volcanic eruption take place is 1883, second is 1927, and again the eruption is take place is 1994. It is quiet for a few days and then again eruption took place. Okay, so with more lava flowing out, the island is still growing bigger. The more lava is flowing out and the island is still bigger and bigger. Okay, so here what they are trying to say here, that the old Krakatoa and the new one, the new mountain, is also a active volcano. Here the volcanic eruption is took place and the lava is flowing out more and more. So when the lava is flowing out more and more, in 1950 the island has grown at an average rate of 5 inches per week. 5 inches per week they start to growing up, and that's the reason the mountain, it's become huge. Okay, now a part of the old island known as Krakatoa is still visible in the sea. Now what is this Krakatoa? Now here you can see the old island name is Krakatoa, right? The new island name is Anna Krakatoa. So now after what they did, Krakatoa. What they tell, Krakatoa. Okay, Krakatoa, the name of the old island itself. What's the name they put? Krakatoa. And their nose is still visible. You can see this is the new, this is the old. The Krakatoa island is still visible. Come to the next. After Krakatoa's eruption in 1883, as I explain you how it took place, the volcanic eruption in 1983, all the surrounding island disaster means which is happened by the nature. Okay, a dangerous situation is happened by the nature, not by the man. That is called a natural disaster. Okay, this thing maybe you learn from your science about the disaster. That is happen a dangerous situation by the nature, not by the man. So by 1883, this disaster took place. At that time, no life is there. The surrounding island, the surrounding coast is also destroyed. No life is remained there. When the scientists visit in 1884, because it take place in 1883, after 1 year, when all the thing is settled down, after 1 year, 1884, scientists when come back and see the situation of Krakatoa mountain, he found just only one spider there, because there is a no life is remain. Okay, but after few years, the living world on Krakatoa was not lost. Now Krakatoa, as I told you, that the old mountain name is Krakatoa, but then after few years later, they changed the name of Krakatoa and they put Krakatoa. What they put? Krakatoa. Okay, and new island name is Anakrakatoa. New island name is Anakrakatoa. Old island name is two name. First is Krakata, and then after they put Rakata. Was not lost and not gone forever. What? Living world. Living world, that means not a human beings are settled over there. Only the animals and plants slowly, slowly settle over there. Okay. So, and how it's happened? Because the winds, the sea, and the few birds have brought the seeds of plants on the island. Some seeds are there. Plants and animals start. Like ants, rats, lizard are stay over there. They teeming. Teeming this, that means the area is full of the plants and animals. They started to live over there. Not a huge animals, only just a few animals are start to floating over there. They start to live over there on the edges of the island. They started to live over there. And soon the full of land is with covered of plants and few animals. So that means in a Rataka, the life, it's not fully destroyed. Plants and animals still live there. Not a human being, only just plants and few animals. It was like a laboratory. Everyone know where the scientists are doing experiment over there. So the scientists are saying the places look like a laboratory where the scientists are see how the living things slowly, slowly developed in an area. Because after the volcano eruption, there is no life. But slowly, slowly, just because of the plant seeds, as you can say, there is a water animals also, land animals also, some small insects. They started to grow up there. So scientists are saying that places look like a laboratory, that how the living world, how the life is start to grow up there. And can observe this all the part of Anakrakatoa, which does not get covered with volcanic ashes. Okay, and this is which part? This part is where the no volcanic ashes you found over there. The western coast of Java was greatly affected. The western coast of Java, as I told you student before only, that Anakrakatoa, this island is between Java and Sumatra Island. Okay, so because of Krakatoa eruption, the Java is greatly affected. As see, suppose this is Anakrakatoa and this is the Java island. So just because of this eruption, the Java is animals and plants in that area grew in large number because no human beings are there. So the wildlife grew naturally. Since there are the wildlife grew naturally. Human beings are there, so they try to cut the trees. They try to kill the animals. They make their houses. So because of this volcanic eruption, which has happened in Anakrakatoa, it's affected nearby the sea also, in a Java place also. So there is no human beings is stay or settle over there. They go very far away, settle down in another places. And just because of this, there is no human being. So wildlife, it started to grow up in a large number. So there are the very big animals, all dangerous animals, and the plants and forest are there. So you can see this region is become a rich in wildlife. So there is a wildlife. So Anak Krakatoa, there also are just a little bit plants and animals are there, but just because of that volcanic eruption, the Java Island, which is near to that, the human beings also destroy over there and they go away, and there also a wildlife is there. So where the volcanic eruption took place, it is very difficult to human being to stay over there because the mountain is collapsed. They throw out the lava, the fire, and this kill, and they can kill to the human being. The human being can die. They cannot survive their life. It is not possible. So that's the reason they are not stay over there. Only just a wildlife begin to grow there. Okay, so this is about the Anak Krakatoa. In this lesson, what we'll see, first we see the old Krakatoa story, volcanic eruption take place. Because of the volcanic eruption, a new island is grow, and the new island name is Anak Krakatoa, or you can say the child of Krakatoa. But you can observe new island and the old island also, Krakatoa. And the old island name, you can say a Rataka also. Okay, so here our lesson is over.